Your bag off the wall. Talk about fucking warning bells. It's pushing wet with the gales, and there's this lassie walking down Queensferry Road, which is fucking deserted. She's heading towards the Fourth Road Bridge, and at this time, in this fucking weather. A fair's a fair bit, eh? And besides, the jumpers are usually gadgets. Very seldom do you get Farry trying to top and sell that way. Aye, they sent us on this course so you could spot the jumpers. They tell you all the things you need to say to stop them, like counselling and that. I mean, none of that ever fucking bother, eh? Fuck all that nanny state fucking George Bernard Shaw's. Some cunts made their mind up about it, they must have a good fucking reason. It's not for the likes of a total stranger to say any different. Wouldn't it be me anyway? Jump over a cliff. Then some bird phones you up the next day, deciding that she's going to give you your whole after off. Fuck that. Too much to live for me, but eh? Mind you, I can understand that some gadgets that aren't getting a ride, how they would want to jump. Fuck that for a game of soldiers. But with a bird that's different, nobody in the right mind wants to see a good fanny going to waste. A bird's mind just meant to be all hawk for the rumpy pumpy. No call stretched out in a slab. But there's some dirty cunts that would go for that. I blame that fucking internet, letting bears watch extreme porn before they've even had a proper wank. That shite would fuck any cunt see that. Too right. I mean, I've made the odd scud flick, eh? But it's like being consenting adults. No dodgy stuff. So I stops, and the lassie gets in the cab. Her black hair's plastered to her head by the rain. Her long black coat's all heavyweight, and her eyes are fogged over. All right, all. Bit blustery to be, eh? Never heard of ball bag. But this bird, she's just sitting there, staring off into space, with her big eyes, probably brown, set in a roundish face. The lights are on, but there's no cunt in. The bridge. She says in this accent it's either posh Scottish or English. So, what's happening at the bridge then, eh? She suddenly looks at us all offended like it's none of my business. Did he look at us like that? I'm going. Not with that fucking moosey face on. See if you jump off that bridge. It's my case with bullets going. I've got to ask the question. She's looking right at us in that wide-eyed horror, like the birds in the movies, like Scream, but kind of not like Scream, because her moose saw chucked tight, like a fucking rumble dump. But that's up to you, I shrugs. Your business, just tell us if you are, so I can give the business some cover story. Like you tell us you were going to your sister's in Inverkeithen, then you were sick and had to get out to puke, and the next thing you'd couch yourself out of the fucking rail. That sort of shite. She puts her head in her hands and mumbles something that I didn't catch. Then she jumps up and goes, I can get out of here. No, I'll take you to the bridge, shakes my head. The way I see it, if you're determined to jump, you will. And it's kicking up big time outside, you might as well go in comfort. And she doesn't even flinch at that. Tell you one thing, I put her in the picture. You're not going to get this cab to pay your fare first. I wasn't. I've got money. She reaches into her purse. How much? £70 and some change. No being wide, I goes glancing in the mirror, but you might as well just hand it all over. Just it would be a wasted dosh of it, eh? Jumping there with all that in your pockets. I'm not being wide, like. Bird looks so angry, staring at us for the first time. Then she sort of shrugs and sails back into the sea. If I was ever in any doubt that this was the right time to leave this fucking place, you would have convinced me. And she reaches forward again and shows the contents of the purse. I stops at the red light, turns and reaches through the Judas hole to take the poppy and crams it in my pocket. The road's empty, thank fuck. I'm not being funny, like, and I'm not trying to stop you, Jen, up. But I've got to ask, what's a good-looking young lassie want to do that for? You wouldn't understand. She shakes her head. Nobody does. Well, explain it to us, I goes, because this isn't that course. Get them fucking talking. What's your name? I'm Terry, by the way. I get Kent as Juice Terry, because I worked on the juice lorries way back. Sometimes Scud Terry, because, well, I'm not going to bore you with it. My name is Sarah Ann Lamont, she says, like she's a robot. I get called Sal, Sarah Ann Lamont. So you've got up here then, Sal? Yeah, Portobello originally, but I've lived in London for years. Lamont, you said, aye? Yeah. Just as well as any fucking Lawson. Right, fuck, man. You're going to check. With that cunt and all, man of mine, I've been chucked his spunker in the field like a lunatic spray and a file of moss. What's it you did do here, like, what line of work are you in, dog? Another bitter wee shrug and she pushes their wet tresses of hair out her eyes. A right place. Now the rest of the world seems to disagree. No fella down there, maybe they'll be worried about you. Ha! She laughs, what sort of cynical. I'm fleeing an emotionally abusive relationship. I'm back in my home city with a specially commissioned play, The Traverse. It was supposed to be the return of the prodigal daughter, but the critics have not been kind and I've had enough. Does that answer your question? So you're going to kill yourself over a failing in a play? You don't understand. Find another belly! Write another play if that year was shite! First wrote this bit in the war scud click once. You do like it up him. Wasn't that great? But it didn't deter me. It wasn't shite! She goes, now I'm here for the first time. You don't get it. I'm not surprised. Alright, so the bird's going to be fish food in 20 minutes. But I'm not that fucking struck in a batter, but eh? Oh, I see. I didn't understand because I just drive a cab, is that it? Because I drive a taxi, I can't be expected to understand the complex mind of an artiste. I didn't say that. I've done a fair bit of acting, I'll tell you. No stage, but screen, and I understand the process. People think Scud's just about banging away, but as my mate Sick Boy says, we're telling a story here. You've got to ken your lines and you've got to hit your mark. I'm not saying that I'm fucking Brad Pitt, but then again, I'm not saying that cunt's Juice Terry. Last year we were shooting this film, Doctor Scheme, A Thorough Examination. Stick one thermometer up this bird's fanny, the other up her arse and say, the Horace Hall's the one that gets his fat dick, baby. Sounds fucking straightforward enough, but it's not that easy when there's cameras on you, lights shining in your coupon, a boom mic overheat, and Sick Boy fucking prancing about shouting orders at you. And she's all off on one bit though, eh? Oh, good, let them talk, the boy in the courses, let them talk. All I ever wanted to do was write. 4 years of my life went into that play. They didn't get it, they didn't get me. The sneering men, I could understand that sad cabal of old queens, but when the jealous fucking so-called sisters turned on me, she shakes her head, letting the wet lulls fly. Now, I've had enough. There's no lot you can say to that. I look at her in the mirror. She reminds us a bit of that bird for Liverpool that I made Anal Torpedo 3 with. That was when I played the captain for the whaling ship, crewed by birds, all wearing fishnet tights. Catchphrase, there she blows. She's gone all quiet as they're passing the bar and roundabout, her hands clasped together, on her lap, he'd bowed, staring at them. So I think, fuck it, I'll make a wee move. Listen, this might seem a wee bit cheeky, son, but can I ask you a favour? She looks at us like I'm fucking tapped.
What?
You want a favour? From me? What favour can I do for anyone now? Well, we're just wondering. See if you weren't in any big curry, I shrugged, gaining a cheeky wee smile. Any chance you're right before you jump? What? Her face sort of twists and then she's silent again. It suits me. She's not saying aye, but she's not saying no. I was just wondering, Sal, kind of maybe it's a wee bit cheeky, but the quiet burn gets now. Maybe going with a bang, last night on earth, I guess. Tell you what, I give you a good fucking count, pardon my French. You want to have sex with me? Suicide Sal laughs, her voice going all high, like she can't believe what she's hearing. And fuck, she's getting out her coat and pulling off her jumper. She's sitting on a black bra. Go ahead, pull up, do what the fuck you like. And I does it all right, heading off that slip road just before the toll bridge comes into view. The howling wind is that strong, I can barely move the fucking door at first. But with a ride in its back, it could be turned on its side, buried in an avalanche, and I'd still be able to fucking roll. Fasten your seatbelt, head, I shouts to her, because we could be in for some offy, bumpy, rumpy, bumpy! Thanks again, folks.